Jay Staples, Sober Caddy, Sober Caddy Chronicles, and you know, slowly getting through some of these questions and so forth like that. And you know, one is what I always talk about, my three principles that I built my personal long-term recovery on. And it's not in any book or anything like that. It's just in what I decided to. I believe in unity and fellowship and service wholeheartedly, not dismissing anything like that. But for me to get truly into long-term recovery, I build my recovery on authenticity, vulnerability, and connection. The three things I always, I hate talking about, but I also love talking about at the same time. And all too often, we're finding people thinking that they can do it on their own. And all too often, we're finding people that are not willing to accept feedback, you know, even from good friends or people that know and love them, and they know deep down don't have ill will towards them. They still respond very harshly to criticism, to feedback, to whatever. I always took it as criticism. I always thought that they were cutting me down, and I instantly went to, I'm a bad person. I'm not worthy or anything like that. And so when I learned to become vulnerable, and it was a tough, tough thing to learn, but what that looks like for me is to be held accountable by a group of people I meet with, an accountability group that holds me accountable and kind of holds up a mirror as to how I'm showing up in every aspect of my life, not just in recovery. And I ask for help. I still do it all the time. When people ask me how I'm doing, I'll normally my first response is good or fine. I try to circle back and say, actually, it's been, having a real good time. I'm having a good day. I'm living in the moment. And I also have to be open to letting them know when I'm struggling and when I know that I'm losing my temper or whatever it may be. Yesterday, I had a session and very, very rare occasion, I lost my cool, and we started getting in a heated argument, and that's not my role, and that's not how I like showing up, and I have to circle back and, make sure that I right the wrongs and take a look at how I'm showing up. And, one of the very first things I did was call support group and call guys, some men that I respect and let them know what happened. And we talked about what caused it and so forth like that. And, whatever the reason may be, it's no excuse to get in a heated argument. And as much as I want to justify that it was worth it, but that's not the case. And then once you start getting vulnerable, when you start reaching out to people, a connection is going to be had. You keep doing that. There's no way you can't find a true connection. And so your vulnerability leads to connection. And once you do that, you gotta learn the authentic self. And to me, that's the hardest thing, the real Jay. The little Jay, who is trying to get connected to little Jay, and who the real me is. And going back to, what he felt, there wasn't this shame and I'm not worthy and I'm not good enough and I'm a bad person back when I was 6-7 years old. And so I kind of have to channel that. And I need through vulnerability and connection, I need to let people know the real me, because that's the only way you can be held accountable. When you start doing things out of character, away from what you truly do and whatever are, then you start getting held accountable, and you do that through connection. You have to be open and honest to what everyone has to say. Finding the real me is ultimately the biggest turning point in my recovery, and got me into long-term recovery, and dealing with the shame and the guilt. And it's an ongoing process, and I'm still learning probably more and more about myself each and every day. I do that by putting recovery first. I put recovery first in every aspect of my life, and I start rewriting the stories. I don't allow myself to write the ending of any story, because if given the opportunity in the moment, I'm always going to go negative. We gotta start building on the positives, and we gotta start rewriting that to turn out positive.